As you can see, I've tidied up the HTML for my notes display and made it slightly less horrific to look at. I did that by adding some new CSS in this demopad.less template, which I've then referenced up here in my demopad index template with an XFCSS call, which calls that particular less file. And then I've it just restyles all the stuff that's in the template. There's nothing really more than there was in the previous step when we built it the first time round. I've just rearranged it and applied some slightly less eye-bleeding styling to it. What I've also done is I've changed the sort order of the posts from post date descending, which made it newest first, into post date descending, ascending, so that the first post is at the top and the last post is at the bottom. And I've gone ahead and I've added a bunch of extra posts. And why have I done that? Well, because I want to show you how to do pagination so that you don't have to have everything shown on one single page. So if we look in the notes controller and recall the root format, we had this colon page parameter, and that means that page numbering is going to be handled in a special way. Specifically, the page number is going to be passed through the parameter bag, like the note ID is passed when we do action edit. So we need to get hold of the parameter bag and reference it in our action index because we're going to make use of it. So the page number will be params page because it just takes the name of that. And then we need to set up how many items we want per page. And I've set up 21 notes for that page. So let's say that we want a per page of 8 so that we get 3 pages of posts. And then we need to apply an extra filter to the note finder. And it looks like this. We just say note finder limit by page. And then we pass it the page and the per page. And with that, it can work out how to slice the complete set of notes that it would have otherwise found according to the page that we've specified. So if you're taking page 2 with a per page of 8, then it's going to start page 2 with item number 9. So then we need to pass these parameters into the template so that the page numbering builder can access them. So let's do that here. We want page, which is the page, and we want per page, which is the per page, and then we're also going to make use of total, which, as you will recall, is a function of the finder. So there we are. Now, total is very clever insofar as it does not take account of the limit by page. So even though this limit by page will limit the number of results that are returned to fetch to 8 at the maximum, the total call will give you the number of results that would have been returned had you not applied that limit. And that means that you can work out how many pages you're going to need. So let's save that out and go and add the page numbering system to the template itself. Here we are in the template, and I'm going to stick it underneath the block container here so that it's just between the block container and the body. So here we are, and I'm going to have an XF page nav. Of course, I've got a shortcut for it, but here's the basic structure. We need to tell it what the page is, as in what variable we're using, and that's page and per page and total. So we almost always use those named variables. And then we need a link, and this is going to be the root that we should use as the link for when we create a page link. And in this case, we're just using the index action of notes, so it's just notes. There is no content and there are no params, params being additional filters or things that you need to apply in the link builder. So we don't need any of those. And then we're going to wrap the page nav up in a block outer after class, which will just make it appear correctly at the bottom of the list of items. So let's head back to the template and refresh. And what we should find now is that we have suddenly got a page nav. And when we click onto page two, then here we are, we're on page two, and we've started with post number 9. And we go up to post number 16 before we switch over to page number 3 and get the remainder. Now, I did say that we were going to show you both ways of doing pagination. This is the way where the page number becomes part of the URL without entering the query string. But we could also make it as part of the query string by doing this. Let's go back to one without the parameters there. Go into the root and remove that colon page and save that. And to compensate for that change, I need to change this here, where we looked for the page variable in the params, to this filter page, because now it's going to be coming through the query string. I can leave that there, that's redundant now, but doesn't hurt to leave it. And when I refresh now, then the links to the pages will now include a question mark page equals 2. So it's now putting it into the query string rather than building a sort of SEO friendly URL. Actually makes no difference, it's entirely down to your own particular tastes. But if you know that you're going to be doing lots of numbering, then you might prefer to use the parameter-based version.